So now let's have a look at how we can use our newly found knowledge of brush parameters, especially now we're going to try and affect our standard brush set. I think before we go on, we should revert to something we're a little more familiar with. So I'm going to change the particles brush back to real watercolor. And it's Remember the Brush, and we had quite a lot of success with the noisy flow map fringe. So we'll stick with it. And I'll just make a quick mark on the paper just to show you that we shouldn't be seeing anything we're not expecting. There's actually quite a lot going on here. There's how the pigment picks up, there's evaporation rate, there's weight, there's even things we can change like wind factor. And I'm going to show you how to do that now. We would go into our window and we would drill down to our brush controls panel, and we're looking for the real watercolor, which is the top tier of the subset that we're using. So if you remember, we're using noisy flow matte fringe, and there's all those various brushes. But its head section is called real watercolor. So we'd have to drill down this submenu to find it. And there it is. And then our specific dialog box will pop up. A lot of this is kind of predictable. And obviously you can experiment yourself. That's the whole point. But I'll give you a quick demo of the changes that you can affect by just moving a few of these sliders around. A lot of artists that I know like to work with a kind of dry brush method. So in order to achieve that, we would slide the wetness down to something below 10%. And also we could remove a little of the settling rate. Now what we're going to get is a totally different mark. You can see how it's gone. I mean, that's not settling at all. So I mean, maybe we should try a little higher value. Let's try 65%. You see how you get this workable dry brush feel. In fact, it looks a lot like a visualizer's marker. So there is a lot of variety and a lot of things that can be achieved just by moving those sliders around. Now, the problem with experimenting like this, especially if you're working on a composition, if you're messing around with the brushes and you think, God, the default palette was perfect for me, and you didn't make a note, and no one would really expect you to make a note of every possible variable that Corel opens up with. But one quick trick, if you want to go back to the beginning, save you a lot of headaches. If you go into the brushes menu from the top toolbar, you will see you have an option called Restore Default Variant. So if you want to go back to the original setting, you click that. If you've been using multiple brushes and you've made a right mess, you can choose Restore All Default Variants. And I'll give you a quick warning. As soon as you click that, you'll see that we go back to our original setting. So that's effectively how you handle the pigment on the paper. And I'll just show you another quick thing before we finish this module. If I change the paper roughness, or I increase it, we'll see under the brush that more texture appears. So you can even change the feel of the paper per brush stroke, which can get some really nice effects going.